Hello everyone, myself Girish Shinde. Today I am developing a traffic signal using timer in VB.NET. Initially start the Visual Studio. You can use any version of Visual Studio. I am using Professional 2012. Click on New Project. Click on Windows. Select Windows Form Application. Give the project name as a traffic signal. Click on OK. This is the initial view of Visual Studio. This is a form. You can resize it. This is property window. This is toolbox. You can use different controls from toolbox. So for designing traffic signal, I'm using shape control from toolbox. There are three types of shape: line shape, oval shape, and rectangle shape. So click on rectangle shape. It is used to design a stand for traffic signal. Resize it as per your requirement. Okay, change the background color. So first of all, click on control. You can see that rectangle shape 1. I have selected second shape, then it is rectangle shape 2. Every shape, every control have its unique name. So click on control, goes into the property window, change the back color. That is, can use any color. But no change. So you have to change second property, that is back style. Initially it is transparent, you have to change to opaque. Okay, same thing for second control. Okay, so use the oval shape for lights. You have to use three oval shapes for three different lights: red, yellow, and green. You can drag and drop three different ovals, otherwise you can copy paste by using Ctrl C and Ctrl V. Change the back color of three ovals. First one is red. Change second property, that is back style. Same for second shape, this is yellow. Next one is green. First oval shape is named as oval shape 1, second one is oval shape 2, and third one is oval shape 3. You can change the name as per their color. That is, first one is red, second one is yellow, and third one is green. Use the timer control from toolbox. This is different control because it not shown on form, it goes at the bottom. Initially timer not enabled, it is false. So change the property of enable property, make it true. Okay, our design view section is completed. So next one is coding session. So double click on timer. So it's your coding session. Before going to coding session, we will see the one picture. Coding is very simple in that you have to use one variable I. Initially it is 0, the value of I is 0. Just read it. When the green light is on, if the value of I variable is in between 0 to 100, then green light is on. If the value of I variable is 101 to 150, then it's yellow light. And red light, when the value of I variable is 151 to 250, then the red light. After 250, what? If the value of I variable is becomes 250, then it again reset, that is, it set as a zero. So same process repeated again and again. Okay, so coding session. So declare the variable I, deem I as a integer is equal to zero. Set the value of I as a zero. Okay. Okay. For the green light, if the I variable is in between 0 to 100, then use the condition. You have to use the control structure. If I is less than 100, because initially it is zero, so I is incremented till it becomes 100, then you have to use the visible property of OL, that is, if the I is in between 0 to 100, then the green OL visible property is true and remaining two OLs property is false, but it you have to do at runtime. So by using coding you can do it. So red dot visible is equal to false. Okay, red means what? OL, because you have changed the name of OL. OL name is red, this OL name is yellow. Okay, so don't confuse. So yellow dot visible is equal to false. Okay, and initially green light is on, so green dot visible is equal to true. Okay, this is done for green light. Okay, next one is for yellow light. If I is greater than 100, okay, greater than 100, and I is less than 150, then yellow light visible. Okay, so red dot visible is equal to false, yellow dot visible property is equal to true, and green dot visible property is equal to false. Okay, got it. And then next one is for red light. If I is greater than 150 and I is less than 250, then red dot visible is equal to true, yellow dot visible is equal to false, and green dot visible is equal to false. Okay, this is done for three lights, but the counter of I variable is incremented at every tick of timer. Okay, so let's I is equal to I plus 1. I is incremented by 1 at every tick of timer, but the you have to reset the timer after the value of I 250. So give the condition, if I is equal to 250, when the I becomes 250, then again you have to set the I is equal to 0. Okay, so let's check the save the project, execute the program by clicking start. Initially green light, and that means you can go. After some time yellow light will be visible. Okay, yellow light means what? Go fast and don't cross the zebra line. Red light means stop the car or bike. After yellow, again green light. Anyway. Okay. Thank you.